Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, grade fives. I hope you guys are doing really well. Today's video is about the investigation on how long candles will burn, right? So our focus is on the candles, how long they will burn, depending on the amount of oxygen that they will receive. Okay, so this investigation is in your textbook, right? So you are able to do this yourselves, obviously under supervision, or you might even be able to do it on site. If not, then that is what this video is for. You will observe and then answer questions afterwards, inshallah. Okay, right, so let's get started. Okay, so let's look at what you need to do this experiment. Okay, so I've got two jars that are of different sizes. Okay, I've got my matches, I've got a regular candle, okay, and a ruler to measure the pieces of the candle that I'm going to cut. Okay, now I decided not to actually cut it on camera. I did it already and I burnt it so that the wicks are open, right? So you know the wick is the part of the candle that needs to burn, right? Okay, let me just zoom in there. Gosh, right, okay, there you see the wick is burnt. Okay, so I've got my three different candles and each candle is 5 centimeters long. Okay, so I measured using the ruler 5 centimeters on this candle and then I cut it up, right? So I got three pieces out of that. Okay, so in the textbook they tell you to use 10 centimeter long candles, but I didn't have a jar that would fit over a 10 centimeter candle, so I chose 5 centimeters each. All right, okay, so this is what we're going to do. I'm going to light each of the candles. All right, I'm going to move this aside. I'm going to light the three candles and then we are going to place the jars over two of the candles and the one will remain open. Right, so there's no wind. I'm doing this inside the house and we're going to observe what happens and then you guys will answer questions after that. Okay, right, so let me just set this up. All right, sorry, love. Okay, right, so I've got my three candles. Okay, there we go. I have to make sure the wicks are the same size. It's very important. Remember, in any experiment, your everything needs to be fair. So you have to make sure that all your all the different components of the experiment are kept constant, right? Okay, so I'm going to put this jar. This one would go over this one, right? The bigger jar, let me just hold it up so you can see how much bigger it is. It's going to go over my second candle. Right, like this. Oh my good grief, it doesn't fit. Okay, so I'll put it over this one. Right, and then this one will stay over here. Right, okay, you can see my handcrafted clay container. I finally found use for it, thank goodness. Right, okay, this isn't the greatest, but what can I do? Okay, right, so let me move this back so that you can see properly. Okay, right, okay, right, so I'm going to light up my candles, right, and then I am going to put the jars over and we will observe what happens. All right, come on. All right, so I've got all three of them lit up and now I am going to place the jars over them and observe what happens over 10 minutes. Right. Okay, so Bismillah. Obviously it has to go over at the same time. Right, okay, so oh, that was pretty quick, that happened almost immediately. Right, and then we'll see what happens between the larger jar and the one that has nothing on it. Okay, that was so fast. Right, And that is the end of our experiment. Okay, so we saw what happened between the two, right? We saw the time difference in which it happened, and that is basically the end of this experiment. Right, so you guys can attempt this at home, or, gosh. Okay, so you guys can attempt this at home, or you might get to do it on site, inshallah, but either way, you should be able to answer questions on this experiment. Okay, so, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.